special gift of the sacred pipe to all the peoples so that we can sit in a circle without pretensions and we can all elevate ourselves to a higher consciousness. So I'm glad to see that the times of white buffalo cap women are returning.
First of all, I'd like to thank all of you for coming here today. A lot of my homeboys, a lot of my family, friends that I've met, new friends and old friends. And today we're here to gather together, you know. And this has been going on for years and years and ages and ages. It's a long time, and we continue to do this now. And all I can say is, it's real good to do this wall. I learned a lot. I learned how to work with my brothers here. I did a lot of research to make sure that all of us, that we all put up the right message. Each and every one of us went out to do what we had to do. Basically, about the wall, it's all the native people from South America to Alaska and that have offered gifts to our society, but have never really gotten recognized for it. And it's time we wake up, you know, wake up to what's going on and continue the cycle, you know, spread the message to the young ones, you know, the elders to the young ones, and hopefully we can get that message across. Thanks. Not just here in the United States, but like all the western part of the world, you could say. A lot of stuff that they have gave to us, they haven't made the credit for, and stuff, and society itself has never been given credit for, like, certain medicines that we use today, the things that we wear, the clothes. They all come from certain parts of the western part of the world and stuff. And so this mural is like a tribute to indigenous culture in that sense of bringing awareness of them to us, so that we can all, you know, just become more aware of ourselves and of the earth and where we stand, you know, to take care of the earth, because basically that's like where we should get all our stuff from, you know, and like even reproduce the same way that the earth reproduces different stuff from us. So I just want to thank everybody for coming here, and thank you very much.
First, I just want to thank everybody for coming out today. I know they need kind of tells you to stick around at home for a while, but I'm glad to see the dedication of all the people out here today. And I'd like to also thank the school for all the cooperation. And I'd also like to thank all the other artists here from your crew who I know just from personal experience on that dedication, we make this happen. And what I might call a sacred coincidence. Well, a lot of people are celebrating the anniversary for the travels of Columbus. There's another part of that story that hasn't been mentioned very often, and that's what was given credit of finding, which actually wasn't a lost land at all, and it wasn't a great big frontier. There were people here. There were cultures here. And I don't want to bring any kind of negative air onto it. It's a beautiful scene. But I just want to let you know that we came out here with a mission. And through hip hop, which is a subculture that no one would even think would be remotely involved in a movement like this, we did bring this out to the streets, and we hope the message stays here. Thanks, everybody.
Say that we can make multicultural, autonomous, bioregional societies here in this land that represent us and live side by side with the indigenous nations as true sisters and brothers, and not just the nations of indigenous people, but the nations of the four-legged and the winged and the rooted and the swimming ones and the crawling ones. These are all nations, all with equal rights. And it's time that we unite as one family of sovereign nations on this sacred land. And so I want to conclude with the words of the great Lakota holy man, Black Elk. He said, a sacred nation is appearing. They are appearing. May you behold. And I think here in this mural, we behold the reappearance of the sacred nation. Thank you.
Thank you, Jim. All right, and now for the spiritual aspect and also for the empowerment through the collaboration and through working together with Native youth, I want to introduce a very, very dear brother, Phil Lane Jr., and also John Spitfar, and also, will you introduce, okay, and I'd like to say that the work that is being done at a level that is way beyond political, it's way beyond personal, it's at a level that is deep within, and we're very honored to work with them.
My very beloved relatives, I am very thankful to our beloved Creator that we've come together here in the spirit of unity to begin the process of transforming ourselves and our communities. I believe today will be remembered as a very historic day because the transformation, the change we're all seeking must begin from within. And this is from within the place it needs to begin. And I call upon my brothers and sisters to join with the Earth Ambassadors, to join with the Earth Crew, to join with the people. We are going to bring with us in August 14 of your young warriors from this area to Aspen, Colorado. And in Aspen, we're going to join together with our relatives, the Japanese drummers, and relatives from New York City, from Texas, from tribes across North America. And in those mountains, we're going to forge a unity. We're going to fulfill the prophecies of the people. And those prophecies say nothing less than at this time in history, the young people are going to come together with wise elders, and they're going to do something that the whole world will take up and be changed. So in this thought, I'm going to share this one song in honor of this work that's been done here, and to reach out to my relatives. Mi corazón está lleno de amor por este día, porque la futura, este día va a recordar como un día histórico. Por eso vamos a unir, porque estamos son el mismo sangre, el mismo corazón, el mismo espíritu. Somos miembros de la misma familia, la familia de la humanidad. Por eso quiero dar esta canción sagrada de una mujer muy sagrada en honor de los tribus de América del Sur, América Central y aquí en América del Norte. Este palabra dice y llamar el poder del universo aquí en las cuatro direcciones para cambiar nuestros corazones. now I'd like to introduce you to your really strong spiritual brother, who some of you may know from his work in the movies. But most important, what I know about him is his complete commitment to the transformation of this planet and a heart that's strong. So I call upon our good warriors here, both male and female, to give a good welcome to a good brother, a Delaware Indian, who is also united with other parts of the human family that he's being. So I'd like you to help me welcome our good brother, Gary Busey. It is an honor to be here, to be in this spirit of community gathering, heart to heart. It begins with self-respect. When we can start respecting ourselves, then we can give that respect and love to others. And to see communities, cultures, and races start coming together from all over the world, that's the first step in meeting ourselves with each other and taking this confusion, this fear, and this anger that starts with the government. It starts with the injuries of the earth. The environment is the most precious thing we have going besides ourselves. So when we can learn to love each other, when we can learn to love ourselves first, then we can reach out and extend our hearts to others. And that's what I'm here for. That's one of the reasons I'm here. I was killed 3 years ago in a motorcycle wreck. I went to the other side where the light is. When I came back, I was told it was my choice. I could stay over there and leave this planet and go to the fifth dimension, or I could come back. It was my choice. I came back and I started over. It's taken me 10 lifetimes to get to the point of spiritual commitment and the consideration of all others that exist in front of me. And given the profile I've gained by being a motion picture actor, that's probably the reason I started this funny, stupid, crazy, lovely show business. And listen to this. This is something I learned from being over there. The great tragedy in life is not death. It's what dies inside of you while you're living. And what's living inside of you is yourself and your heart and your own experience of self-acceptance and self-love. When you gather that in you, in the base part of your core, you can extend that to others and you can love others. Expect their limitations to be there because of what they've gone through in their life and extend your value of them to them. And it's like the golden rule. I transformed the golden rule when I came back. You know the golden rule says, do unto others as you would have others do unto you? Well, think of this. Do unto you as you would do unto others. Treat yourself with that respect and kindness that the great spirit, the Lord above, the great higher forces above, gave you to learn by bringing you on this planet. And each one of you here has the power of 10,000. And the reason you're here is to gather in this little bit of information. This will be seeds planted in your head and in your heart. And you can take that to bed with you. You can say a prayer around it. You can meditate. You can treat people you don't know with the kindness you want to be treated with. But first, learn to treat yourself with that kindness. Respect life and respect others and respect yourself. And I'm very happy to be here with you. And I'm going to stay with you. And I'm going to stay with the whole earth this way because that's one of my ego feathers. And I'm here to honor that. Thank you very much for being here, all of you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I love you all.
Hello, my name is John Stiffarm. I'm the representative of the Earth Ambassador Project. The Earth Ambassador Project is an environment program for youth. I want to explain some of the principles and beliefs of the project. Our belief is, as youth, what we wanted to do was to end the environmental destruction and the crisis this world is in today. We wanted to get to the root cause of the destruction and of the crisis. And what we found as a collective, as a group, what we found is that Mother Earth isn't sick, we are. We're the ones that are sick with the pollution inside of us. And that's the hardest thing to accept. That's the hardest thing to have really go deep inside and gather together the will and the strength to change yourself and to grow. And to begin healing yourself, helping yourself. I see all these signs up here with the on the bus stop, the group of chairs. Protect the environment, help the environment. they don't help yourself, the development comes from within. It comes from right here. You got to want to make that change. And this is how you're going to heal the environment, by first healing yourself. This is the belief of the Earth Ambassador Project. I invite any of the younger people here to take part in this project. There's going to be a training in Aspen, Colorado, to really train us to really let the potentials that we have as leaders out. People say that we're the leaders of the future. I say we're the leaders of the present. We have to take the initiative right now, which means taking care of yourself, which means taking that initiative to begin that healing process in yourself. So right now, I would like to share a song. I would like to share a song for my people, the Native American people, the North American Native people. It is a teaching to honor each other. The honor of one is the honor of all. The hurt of one is the hurt of all. There's that community there. And so I'd like to honor the Earth Crew and Helen and all these people involved here with this mural. Honor them with the song. This song belongs to my grandfather. It's an old time honor song. I want to share this with them.
And above that, the dolphin, we're honoring our Chumash brothers.
and the Chumash dancers. We also have in the upper left, we have the Alaskan. The Alaskan peoples were very famous for their art, also their symbolic art. We also have on the right the terracing of the Incas. The Incas used to have uphill irrigation way before they even had. These are way up in mountains that are so high that people can't even get to. Way before electricity and other propellants like gasoline, they had uphill irrigation. We have the Aztec dancers that symbolize the warrior and the strength. And there's a lot of misunderstandings about the Aztecs because people talk about sacrifices and all that, and yet, you know, we think nothing of sacrificing 100,000 young people to war every 20 years. So, you know, let's not talk about sacrifices. I think the true sacrifice we all have to make is to really do better. We should all sacrifice every single day to do better in every way. And also in the lower part, we have some very strange plants from South America. Nuke just came back from Rio. He represented the hip-hop movement down there and got a big wall that's about 15 by 20 that is donated to the Museum of Modern Art there. They have graffiti now down there, which I would also like to thank Chaz and Blaze, because without them, their presence, we wouldn't have even been doing this. And Alan Nakagawa, because they really pulled us together even though we were off doing other things. Chaz has now, at this moment, the Smithsonian has two artworks done by graffiti artist Chaz Bohorquez, who is a veterano, and we want to thank him for being with the guys. He's a veterano with a heart that came back and taught with the guys and is guiding them along. Yay, Chaz! Anyway, another couple more images on the wall is White Buffalo Cat Woman. She brought the teaching of the sacred pipe, where many men and women and children can come together without egos, without pretensions, without, you know, being somebody that they're not, and put their prayers in the pipe and receive the blessings from all the directions, and then send their prayers up to Great Spirit. So her teaching was a very strong one of people, you know, coming together in a sacred way, and I think that that's what we're doing right now. And everybody in a different way. The rap artists have their own music. I think hip hop is the most strong culture that we have going nowadays, and it's the blessed culture. I think it's got music, it's got graffiti, it's got breakdancing, and you're gonna see the place rock in a few minutes. So I wanna know, is everybody ready? All right, I wanna introduce a slang underground. No, hold on.
Peace, how's everybody doing today? I'm AJ and I'm down with OMCs in the house.
I'd like to thank our crew and thinking for Night of the Bees, a part of this beautiful mural that they do. In the spirit of the earth and the spirit of indigenous people, because it's 500 years since the white man came. This year marks 500 years, and yet these people are celebrating our demise, celebrating our rape, celebrating our brainwashing, celebrating the fact that we are not who we are. I'm not speaking to you in my language. Even when I speak Spanish, I'm not speaking to you in my language. Anyways, when fear of resistance are at the end of the big old Chitano! Chitano!
Viva!
Fuck the red, white, the blue.
They're supposed to get off now.
All right, big clap, for this is wonderful. Woo! What they've done is they've brought spirit into their music and into their lives, so that's great. So I'd like to introduce our brothers from the south, the Xipetotec, the New Spring. And they're going to do an Aztec dance, and I want you to know that Aztec dancers are warriors. They're disciplined.
And I become the greatest of the greater. Then any sin is up to take a man with a Muslim revolutioner, double executioner, and a black race uniter, black power fighter,
covered
with a first secret.
Good to see so many
Indian people here today. We don't recognize any borders up there by Canada or down there by Mexico. All you Chicano people and Mexican people, you have Indian people as your ancestors. It's good to see you here. We're talking a lot about a lot of different things here, about each other and about this Mother Earth. Our elders, they tell us something sort of similar to what Gary said earlier. We don't have to be afraid of death. Death is all right, the spirit world, it's okay. It's unnecessary suffering that we're concerned about. And unnecessary suffering is produced from an unnatural world. We're told to live a good life, we have to follow the original instructions. For Indian people, the original instructions are our ceremonies. They came from spirit. And each of these ceremonies were blueprints how to live a good life and how to be a happy two-legged. Well, we hear a lot of things about this new world order. And what we're trying to come back to, what we call a natural world order. Something that is connected to this earth. Something that comes up from the ground. All of these ceremonies, they stem from nature. Nature provides us with the original instructions. If we're going to make things any better than they are right now, our elders tell us we're going to have to go back and follow the original instructions. That is, participate with nature, pay attention to nature. Underneath this concrete, this pavement, this earth, out there away from the sea, is nature. It's important for any of us to spend time in nature. That's where our ceremonies will take place. We've been very fortunate to be involved with Helen and the Earth Crew. We want to ask Crater for a special blessing on them. They have invited us to allow them to be involved in traditional Native American ceremonies. And that's what we do at the Choro Grande Native American Spiritual Encampment in the Los Padres National Forest. We make traditional ceremonies available to all four races of people. If anyone is interested in more information on that, you will see myself or see Helen. Please remember the sky. Please remember our mother, the earth, Muhammad Tafarasi. Get you might have told the police.
So far away to speak here. For the Earth Crew, they painted a beautiful mural.